You are listening to The Voice of the Gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Gospel by Wisdom Ministries.
January 22nd, Friday. Let's begin this day with the blessings of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark chapter 3, verses 13 to 19. He went up the mountain and called to him those whom he wanted. And they came to him, and he appointed 12, whom he also named apostles, to be with him and to be sent out to proclaim the message and to have authority to cast out demons. So he appointed the 12, Simon, to he gave the name Peter, James, son of Zebedee, and John, the brother of James, to whom he gave the name Boanerges, that is, sons of thunder, and Andrew, and Philip, and Bartholomew, and Matthew, and Thomas, and James, the son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, and Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear friends, Jesus goes up your mountain. It has no name because it is a symbolism that is more important than the location. Mountains is the in the scriptures are holy places associated with the presence of God. Jesus goes up mountains at more solemn moments in his public life. Here, during the Sermon on the Mount, at the Transfiguration, and after feeding the 5,000 people. Jesus' purpose on this occasion is to pick the inner circle of his followers. They were those whom he wanted. Later, he will say, I have chosen you, you have not chosen me. And they came to him. A call includes both the invitation and the response. A call includes both the invitation and the response. The same is true for each one of us. The call is always there. Can we say the same about our response? There were 12 in this inner circle of disciples. In the new covenant, they would be the patriarchs, the foundational pillars of the new community, embracing the new Israel. They are called apostles. The word to be clearly distinguished from apostles, the disciple, which comes from the Latin word meaning to learn, is essentially a follower who imbibes the teachings of the teacher and tries to make it part of his life. The apostle, however, from a Greek word meaning to go out on a mission, like an ambassador, is essentially one who has a mandate for the teacher to pass on to others. In the Pauline letters, where the term appears most often in the Christian Testament, it means primarily who has been a witness of the risen Lord and has been commissioned to proclaim the resurrection. Paul himself, because of his experience at Damascus, is regarded as an apostle. These 12 were to be Jesus' companions. They were to preach, that is, proclaim his message of kingdom and work with him to make it a reality. They were to cast out demons to liberate people from all situations, which enslaved people to any form of evil. The list is headed, as are all lists of the apostles, Simon Peter. For Mark, the name Peter was given on the occasion. In Matthew, it is given later, following his confession of Jesus' identity. Strangely, the list included one man who would betray his master and Lord. And today, there are still those called by Jesus who betray him. What about me? Is it I, Lord? There go I, but for the grace of God? Amen. May God bless us.